Missiles from U.S. ships, Air Force, and Navy planes are striking parts of Syria today. Five Middle Eastern nations are actually part of the military action against ISIS strongholds in Syria. I'm Virginia Cha.
And I'm Bill Griffith. This morning, the president explained the need for strikes in Syria. First time they've done that. We carried his statement on ABC 10 and live streaming video on 10news.com. ABC's Karen Travers has this midday's new developments.
A powerful assault from the air and sea aimed at ISIS targets in Syria.
We're going to do what's necessary to take the fight to this terrorist group.
Missiles and precision-guided bombs rain down from U.S. stealth bombers, stealth fighters, and Predator and Reaper drones. And from Navy warships, powerful Tomahawk missiles.
Our initial indication is that these strikes were very successful.
The strikes were centered around the ISIS stronghold of Raqqa, but they stretched east to the Iraqi border. The targets were ISIS headquarters, supply depots, command and control centers, and financial centers.
Last night's strikes are the beginning of a credible and sustainable, persistent campaign to degrade and ultimately destroy ISIL.
The U.S. did not act alone. Five Arab nations joined in the airstrikes: UAE, Jordan, Saudi Arabia, Bahrain, and Qatar.
The strength of this coalition makes it clear to the world that this is not America's fight alone.
But there was no coordination with the Syrian government. Administration officials were clear. The U.S. did not request permission or coordinate actions with President Bashar al-Assad's regime. The Obama administration did say it warned Syria, don't engage U.S. aircraft. And it turns out that ISIS wasn't the only target. One-third of the airstrikes were aimed at a little-known al-Qaeda-affiliated terror group known as Khorasan, a group that officials say could be a more dangerous and imminent threat to the U.S. homeland than ISIS.
The intelligence reports indicated that the Khorasan group was in the final stages of plans to execute major attacks against Western targets and potentially the U.S. homeland.
The Pentagon says the U.S. has been watching this group closely for some time, and the terrorists plotting that attack were eliminated in last night's airstrikes. Karen Travers, ABC News, Washington.
Those 200-plus strikes hit a dozen targets in and around the Syrian city of Raqqa. That's right here. The city of Aleppo, where the al-Qaeda faction is just to the west. The U.S. ships involved in this offensive are in the northern Persian Gulf, as you can see right over here, and the Red Sea over here. Now, the Navy isn't saying whether any of the ships or carriers involved are based in San Diego, but seeing as how many of San Diego's ships wind up there on Westpac, the chances are pretty good. Virginia?